Princess Fia, and this is my Lalaloopsy doll, Princess Crumpet Hearts.
And I'm Princess Jackie, and this is Princess Suzette La Sweet. And the little sisters have come to help too. Mimi La Sweet.
And Teacup Hearts.
Today we're planning a royal princess birthday party for Kando Slicer Cake's birthday.
For royal confetti poppers, you'll need
a toilet paper tube,
a balloon with the closed end cut off. Be sure to ask a grown-up for help.
Confetti, which can be lots of things. Pieces of ribbon, yarn, paper, doilies, even circles of paper from your hole puncher.
Hole puncher or safety scissors.
Things to decorate the outside of your popper, like washi tape, glitter pens, old magazines, and stickers.
Tape,
craft glue,
and a bowl.
Firstly, pinkies up. Then, tie the open end of the balloon.
You wrap it around like this and put it through the middle.
Now, what you want to do is take the balloon that is cut by a grown-up and pull it down on your toilet paper tube as tight as possible.
Tape the balloon to the tube. Make sure it's very tight.
Now, let's Lalaloopsify our confetti poppers.
Yay!
I'm using blue.
I'm using pink, and my balloon matches it.
I'm going to tape it down just a little bit so it doesn't wobble around.
Now I'm gonna decorate it. Now I'm gonna put some stars.
Mine is going to be all blue too. I think I might use this glittery blue. Confetti time!
Yay!
For confetti, you can hole punch or use safety scissors. You can use ribbon, paper, or doilies.
Doesn't have to be perfect. Now, scoop the popper in the bowl of confetti, but only fill it up about an inch or else it will get stuck. Make sure to keep it upright or everything will fall out.
It's our royal duty to test these confetti poppers.
Oh, yes. And I take my royal duties very seriously.
Make sure to point it up and out of faces. Hold it down and...
Yay! Oh, I mean, very good, very good.
Chip, chip, cheerio.
Whoa, what do you think, Candle? Look at the table. Yum. Look at all the decorations. Wow.
Hello?
Surprise! Happy birthday!
Yay! Hi, everyone. I'm Princess Jackie, and this is my Lalaloopsy doll, Princess Suzette La Sweet.
I'm Princess Fia, and this is Princess Crumpet Hearts.
And I'm Princess Sierra, and this is Wishes Slice O' Cake.
And I'm Princess Leah, and this is Candle Slice O' Cake. And today is her birthday!
Yay!
Yay!
All that's left is to make our Lala lovely birthday cake cup.
I can't wait, Lala. Let's get started.
For birthday cake cups, you'll need
half a cup of chopped strawberries. Ask an adult to cut them for you.
1 tablespoon of melted butter. Ask an adult to melt it for you.
1 tablespoon sugar.
3/4 cup of graham crackers.
Something to roll out the crackers with, like a rolling pin or a water bottle.
4 cups for serving.
A bowl for mixing.
A spoon.
Pre-made whipped cream in a container.
Anything you want to top your dessert off with, like candy, sprinkles, or chocolate sauce.
And a large zip top bag.
Let's make these royal birthday cake cups to get this royal birthday party started!
Woo! First, put the graham crackers in the zip top bag.
Now that it's zipped shut, you can use a rolling pin or a water bottle to smash the graham crackers into a fine flour.
Whoa.
Now, pour the graham cracker flour into your bowl and add 1 tablespoon of melted butter. Now, stir it with your spoon.
It looks so good already.
If it's looking too dry, you can always add more butter.
Now, put your graham cracker flour into all 4 cups equally.
Use the spoon to crush it down to form a crust layer.
Scoop in a small layer of chopped strawberries.
Ooh, yum, I love strawberries.
Me too.
Strawberries are my favorite fruit.
Now add a layer of whipped cream, but leave room at the top for another layer of strawberries. Look at that.
Whoa, that's a lot of strawberries, Jackie. Now, for the final touch, add any toppings of your choice.
I prefer just the berries.
I want as many candies as possible.
I'm going to make one more layer of whipped cream.
I'm gonna add some candies also.
Whoa.
Remember, this is a royal party, so pinkies up.
It's Lala party time! Woo!
3, 2, 1!
Woo!
Let's dance! Woo!
Happy birthday to Candle Slice of Cake!
Today, we're making summer ice pops, or as we like to call them,
Lalaloopsicles!
For Lalaloopsicles, you'll need
ice molds, ice cube trays, and paper cups work great too.
Ice pop sticks.
Fresh fruit. We're using blueberries and raspberries. Also, kiwis and peaches already cut by an adult.
Lemonade, or as we like to call it, Lala Lemonade, or white grape juice works too.
And if you want, gummy candy.
2 or more frozen fruit purees in different colors. If they're not already blended, you can ask an adult to blend it for you.
And a spoon.
First of all, put your favorite fruit or gummies into your ice pop mold or cup. Mix it up and have fun.
Oopsie loopsie, one of my blueberries fell out.
Oh no!
Now we'll pour in the Lala lemonade to fill the molds.
That lemonade looks de-la-la-licious.
It really does. It looks amazing.
Make sure to leave space for the ice pop stick.
Yep.
Put the lid on tight.
Now we have to wait for them to freeze. At least 5 hours.
While we're waiting, time to make our next ice pop, the rainbow Lalaloopsicle. Use a spoon to put in the first color of the frozen fruit puree. Puree is just blended fruit, so it's all slushy.
I'm using Sweetie's favorite colors.
Put the lid on tight. Done.
Yum.
Time's up!
Wow, a rainbow in summer!
Now, it's time for
the blind taste test!
Ready?
Yeah!
Are you ready, sweetie?
Are you ready, Mittens?
I think they're ready! 3, 2, 1, go!
I taste a mango.
I taste lemon.
What do you think, sweetie?
What do you think it is, Mittens? It could be that.
I think I got the rainbow Lalaloopsicle one.
That means I got the Lala Lemonade Lalaloopsicle.
Today we're making no-sew hair bows for us and our dolls.
Yay!
For hair bows, we need
pieces of cloth, ribbons, old t-shirts, or jeans, anything you want to put in your hair.
A grown-up to cut cloth into squares for you.
Tulle, it's what tutus are made of.
Hair clips or barrettes. You can get them from old hair bows you want to upcycle or pick up a pack at the store.
String. Anything you have around the house. You can use sewing thread or even dental floss. Get creative.
Clear craft glue to lalaloopsy your bows.
Random items from around the house to decorate with. Buttons, beads, pieces of yarn, ribbon, glitter, sequins, even pom-poms.
Safety scissors.
And glitter tape. That's optional.
Lay out your pre-cut cloth on something flat, like this.
Make sure to get an adult to help you cut the fabric. Only use one piece, so if you have more, you can put it back.
Fold it into a smaller square, like this. Fold it into the middle.
Like this?
Yep, that's perfect. Now fold the other side to the center and make sure that it overlaps a little.
Don't worry if it's not perfectly straight. It'll still look fantastic when it's finished.
Perfectly imperfect. Now we're gonna fold it again, but on the sides. First one side, then the other side. Now flip it over and pinch the fabric in the middle. And ta-da! An instant bow.
You can use your thread to tie a knot where you pinched it in the middle so it stays in the bow shape. I'm gonna use a purple thread to match with my lavender bow.
Or you can use yarn if you like.
I'm gonna tie mine really tight so it doesn't break.
Me too. You don't want it to fall apart while it's in your hair. Now take your hair clip and use some more thread to tie it onto the back of the bow.
I'm gonna get a pretty long piece. You might need a friend to help you tie on your hair clip to your bow.
And I'm done.
Wow, I love it. Can you hold this? And if you don't have a friend handy, you can always ask your parents for help. There we go. Ours look great.
They do. It worked perfectly.
Time to make our bows la-la-lovely.
You don't need glue to make the bows. But to decorate our bows, we're going to be using craft glue.
I'm going to decorate mine with these orange and white fish beads.
I'm going to decorate mine with these mini pom-poms. They're so cute.
Make sure to let the craft glue dry before wearing your bows.
Ding!
Our bows are dry!
I la-la-love them!
Perfectly imperfect.
Now let's make the same bows, but mini, for our dolls.
Yay!
Just fold the cloth to half size.
So fold it to the middle, then you want to overlap it.
Whoa, this bow sure is mini.
Ta-da!
Let me know if you need help.
I think I got it, though. I finished pinning the string around it.
Here you go.
Thank you. Thanks, Toucan.
More buttons. Our dolls are going to love wearing these.
Definitely. One more type of bow to go. And the tool bow doesn't need any glue at all.
First, fold a piece of tool so we can pour things inside. Start with the tool like this.
Then you want to overlap it even more.
It should look like this when you're done folding.
Yep.
It's good to have a friend help you hold it for this part so everything doesn't fall out. Just a little more should be good.
That's the perfect amount.
For sure. Make sure to only fill it up halfway so you can still fold it over and tie it off. Mm.
Now time for the other side.
That's great.
I'm gonna use this green washi tape because it matches with my tool.
You can also tie the string in the middle before you start. I'm gonna put the sequins in. Uh-oh! Oopsie loopsie!
Ready for the other side?
Yep! The last step is to tie your hair clip to the back of your bow with some string!
You can also cover this thread with more washi tape.
Or leave it as it is. Perfectly imperfect.
We're getting really good at this.
I'm done.
Ta-da! Whoa, they're so cool.
Bow beautiful.
I love them.
They're so pretty.
Aw, Scoops is wearing the bow I made for her.
And April is wearing the bow that I made for her.
Aw, it looks so cute on her. Toucan and Cat are wearing.
They're so lovely.
So cute. April, what do you think of our bows? Ooh, Toucan loves the tool.
Cat loves the mini pom-poms.
Aw.
Thanks for coming